The space shuttle Discovery is perched on the launch pad waiting for the countdown to blast off. Inside the ship is Sonny Carter, a man who grew up here in Middle Georgia, and a man who still has a lot of fans on Earth.
He was interested in everything. He was a good athlete and just a good all-around boy. As far as science, he was always a good student. But I never thought he'd be an astronaut. But he could do anything he wanted to.
Doug Fincher used to walk the halls of Lanier High with Sonny from 1963 to 1965. While Sonny trained to become an astronaut, Doug worked with barbecue. And since Sonny couldn't take Doug with him, he's taking Doug's pride and joy.
Sonny, if you love it so much, now why don't you take it up in space? So that's really how it got started. And Sonny said, gosh, that's not a bad idea. Let me see.
Alice says NASA checked the menu and barbecue wasn't on it. So there was a change in the space program at Sonny's request.
The Finchers made the barbecue just like they were making it for any other customer, and they sent something like this to NASA, complete with barbecue sauce. However, when Sonny eats this in space, it won't look like that.
I assume that they'll take what we have sent and make it in a freeze-dried type situation, and then he will heat it or put it in a type thing like microwave, and it will come back to form.
The Finchers say their special recipe passed the pre-flight testing. They say Sonny already tried it, and he says it tastes just the same as it does in Macon, Georgia. Chris Holcomb, Channel 13, Eyewitness News.